Hi everyone, Steve Patterson here from Photoshop Essentials. In this video, I show you how to paste an image into a selection in Photoshop. I'll also show you how to fix the perspective of your image so it matches the image it was pasted into. I'm using Photoshop 2022, but any recent version will work. And I'll start with this image from Adobe Stock. I want to select the area inside the TV so I can paste a different image onto the screen. The screen is just a polygon with straight sides, so I can select it using the polygonal lasso tool. To get to it, I'll click and hold on the standard lasso tool in the toolbar, then I'll choose the polygonal lasso from the list. To use the polygonal lasso tool, you just click around the area you want to select to add points. Photoshop then connects the points with a straight line. So the idea is to click in the spots where the line needs to change direction. With my image, that would be the four corners of the screen. I'll start by clicking in the upper left corner of the screen to add a starting point for the selection. Then I'll click in the upper right corner to add a second point. And I'll add a third point in the bottom right corner. Don't click and drag with the tool, just click to add a point and release your mouse button. And if you make a mistake and click in the wrong spot, press the delete key on your keyboard to undo it. I'll add a fourth point in the bottom left corner, and then to complete the selection, click again on your initial starting point. And the selection outline appears. I'll switch over to the image I want to paste into the selection by clicking its tab. This image is also from Adobe Stock. Select the image by going up to the Select menu and choosing All. A selection outline appears around it. Then copy the image by going up to the Edit menu and choosing Copy. Switch back to the original image by clicking its tab, and then to paste the other image into your selection, go up to the Edit menu, choose Paste Special, and then paste into. And the image is pasted into the selected area. But we do have a couple of problems. My subject needs to be centered within the screen, and because this image is flat, but the TV is on an angle, I need to fix the perspective. So we'll do that next. Notice that the selection outline is gone. That's because Photoshop converted the selection into a layer mask, which we can tell by the layer mask thumbnail in the layers panel. The white part of the mask is the area we selected and where the image is visible, and the black part was the area outside the selection and where the image is hidden. If you hold the Shift key on your keyboard and click on the layer mask thumbnail, you'll turn the mask off and reveal the entire image. Click the layer mask thumbnail again to turn the mask back on and show the image only in the area you selected. Also notice that the area between the image thumbnail and the mask thumbnail is empty. And by empty, I mean there's no link icon. Normally, the image and its layer mask are linked together, which means that we can't resize one without resizing the other. But when we paste an image into a selection, the image and the mask are not linked, so we can resize the image without affecting the mask. To resize it, make sure the image is active, not the layer mask, by clicking the image thumbnail. Then go up to the Edit menu and choose Free Transform. The transform box and handles appear around the entire image, including the areas hidden by the layer mask. I'll zoom out to make the handles easier to see by holding the Control key on a PC or the Command key on a Mac and pressing the minus key a couple of times. And now we can see the handles. I'll drag these side handles inward to the edges of the TV. Then to fix the perspective, right-click inside the transform box and choose Perspective. In perspective mode, dragging a corner handle horizontally or vertically moves the opposite corner along with it, but in the opposite direction. So as I drag the top right handle up, the bottom right handle moves down. Now, sometimes perspective mode is all you need to align the top and bottom angles together. But other times, like with these images, you can't align one without throwing the other one off. Notice how the top angle is now correct, but the bottom angle is not. And if I try to fix the bottom by dragging the corner handle up, well, now the top angle is wrong. So I'll undo that by pressing Ctrl Z on a PC or Command Z on a Mac. To adjust a corner handle on its own, right-click inside the transform box and switch from perspective mode to distort. And now you can drag any corner handle without moving the others. And things are looking better. But I think my subject is too small. I want him to fill more of the screen, which means I need to resize the image again. But before I can do that, I first need to right-click inside the transform box and switch from distort or perspective mode back to free transform. And now I can drag the handles to resize it. And I can click and drag inside the box to reposition the image and move him into the center. It looks like the bottom angle is still a bit off, so I'll again right-click inside the box and choose Distort. Then I'll drag the bottom right handle upward. And finally, I'll drag the image a bit more to the left. When you're done, click the check mark in the options bar to accept it. And there we have it. That's how to paste an image into a selection in Photoshop. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to my channel to learn more about Photoshop. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. I'm Steve Patterson from Photoshop Essentials.